Your politics don't stand on shit. Rudy Acuna, the Father of Chicano Studies, and More by Irma Vargas Rosas, March 7, 2012. Book presentation. At the end of 2011, I went to a nonprofit organization in San Antonio for the presentation of a newly published book. Chicana Power: Contested Histories of Feminism in the Chicano Movement by Maylee Blackwell. What's in a name? In February 2012, I finally finished reading the book, but was left a bit confused about the name, Las Hijas de Cuauhtémoc, Daughters of Cuauhtémoc, so I decided to ask my dissertation jefa. My jefa pointed out key sections of the book, where Blackwell, 2011, explained the name. Gosh, I must have been distracted or falling asleep when I read that section of the book. An important section, I may add. So I was glad to be rereading it. What's in a name? Continued. Blackwell 2011 explains, quote, Las Hijas de Cuauhtémoc was named for the Mexican feminist organization that demanded women's civil and political rights and an end to the Porfirio Díaz dictatorship at the turn of the 20th century. End quote. Reading of page 102, Blackwell 2011. Quote, Las Hijas de Cuauhtémoc worked to reframe masculinist discourses of the movement on several levels. First, Chicano nationalism utilized Aztec Mexica imagery and the concept of Aztlan to narrate a Chicano indigeneity and reclaim a sense of belonging. Aztlan served as a decolonizing imaginary to signify homeland and served as a mode of historical consciousness and a pre-colonial sense of place about the U.S. Southwest. Taking the name Hijas de Cuauhtémoc helped this group of Chicanas align themselves historically and politically with a decolonial imaginary. It located them within a genealogy of resistance by invoking Cuauhtémoc, the last Aztec emperor who resisted the colonial military occupation of Tenochtitlan, and even was said to have plotted rebellions after his surrender and subsequent torture. The act of taking on the name Hijas de Cuauhtémoc had the effect of subverting the silencing mechanism or Malinche complex deployed by Chicano nationalists, who felt that a women's agenda in the movement was divisive. By resignifying women's role in nationalist culture to take on the anti-colonial struggle that Cuauhtémoc symbolized, instead of the vendida or traitor role that Malinche came to mean, the Hijas de Cuauhtémoc carved out a space for Chicana political subjectivity within the movement. More than using memory merely to add women to existing movement narratives, i.e., Aztec princesses or revolutionary sweethearts, the Hijas de Cuauhtémoc shifted the historical terrain of struggle by retrofitting new narratives that engendered the project of liberation. Moreover, their retrofitted memory created new forms of Chicana feminist political subjectivity and refigured gendered forms of representation, which they circulated via their newspaper. End quote. At first, I thought I would read pages 198 to 204 for you, but I won't. I believe it is an opportunity to check out the book for all that it's worth. In short, while Ana Nieto Gomez had numerous publications, community-based research, and service to Cal State University Northridge, the personnel committee of the Chicano Studies Department denied her tenure and recommended 1976, her terminal year. Nieto Gomez's letter of resignation from 1976. Quote, "My involvement with women and my continued differences with the immature PhD, quote-unquote, feudal jefe, who maintains influence over students and faculty through chisme, intimidation, and macho hero worship," end quote. The immature PhD feudal jefe was Chicano historian and personnel committee member Rodolfo Acuña. Rodolfo Acuña, Occupied America, A History of Chicanos, by Rodolfo Acuña. My dissertation, Jefa and Me, Eminem. Acuña's harassing Meili now. Irma, why? Eminem, for having written what she did about him in the book. Irma, so? Who's he to tell her what to write? Eminem, he's the father of Chicano studies. Irma, so? I don't care. Connection to self. If I was able to give my real papa a piece of my mind, then I can give a fake papa more of a piece of my mind. Dear Rodolfo, Blackwell 2011 makes a compelling argument of the events that transpired between you and Ana Nieto Gomez at CSUN in the 1970s. Your actions are illogical. On the one hand, you purported equal rights for Chicanos, right? The Chicano movement. However, on the other hand, you were instrumental in denying Nieto Gomez, a Chicana, tenure at the university when she clearly had met all the requirements. We Chicanas also deserve equal rights, especially from Chicanos.
Dear Rodolfo, what could provoke you to use your position of power against Nieto Gomez? Did she intimidate you? Were you afraid that if she obtained tenure, that she would overshadow your quote-unquote ship in the department and or university?
Dear Rodolfo, I've also heard that you've started harassing Blackwell for having published the events between you and Ana Nieto Gomez. You did what you did. Your politics don't stand on shit. After resigning, Nieto Gomez spent years trying to find a job, all the while being a single mother. Your ethical framework doesn't stand on shit either. My dissertation jefa and me again. Irma, looking at her. Are Chicanas any different from Acuña? Eminem, but that's different. She, Irma, no, tell me. Are Chicanas any different? Eminem, she had all her publications in order and, Irma, again, my question is, are Chicanas any different? Dear Chicana Chicano professors, we graduate students work hard to get to graduate school. ¿Pa qué? ¿Pa que luego utilicen sus posiciones de poder contra nosotras, nosotros? ¿Pa qué? Me pregunto. ¿Pa qué tanto esfuerzo si en muchos casos parece que no nos quieren allí tampoco? Chicana Chicano professors who power trip at the doctoral level. The experiences of people around me and my own experiences. All names forthcoming. I also have to balance this out with Chicana and Chicano professors who don't power trip at the doctoral level. All names forthcoming. Dear Mei Li, I could not end this video without checking your ethical framework too. My BFF was torn when you decided to come between her and her girlfriend several years ago at Malk's. While I know that it takes two to tango, you had a choice. Long legs and mini skirt, yeah, you know what works and you work it hard. You smile like such a lady, innocent and sweet. You drive the man folk crazy, but any girl can see you're just a homemaker. I know what you're doing. You think you're gonna ruin what I got, but you're not. Yeah, you little go-getter. I'll teach you a lesson if you get to messing with my man. You don't stand a chance. Mujeres activas en letras y cambio social, MOGS. Quote, MALCS is a national organization of Chicanas, Latinas, and Native American women working in academia and in community settings with a common goal, to work toward the support, education, and distribution of Chicana, Latina, and Native American women's issues through networking, occasional meetings, and our annual summer institute. MALCS members share information, offer support, and continue our struggle for social justice. End quote. At no moment does it say that Chicanas, Latinas, and Native American women work towards ending relationships. MALCS is not the only organization where this has happened. National Association of Chicana and Chicano Studies. Quote, The National Association for Chicana and Chicano Studies is the academic organization that serves academic programs, departments, and research centers that focus on issues pertaining to Mexican Americans, Chicana, Chicanos, and Latina, Latinos. The association was formed in 1972 during the height of the Chicana, Chicano movement, calling for the development of a space where scholarship and Chicana, Chicano students could develop their talent in higher education. For more than 30 years, students, faculty, staff, and community members have attended the Knox annual conference to present their scholarly papers, many of which have spun into important intellectual pillars." End quote. At no moment does it say that Knox is a space where, quote, scholarship and Chicana, Chicano students could develop their talents in ending relationships, end quote. Where scholarship and Chicana, Chicano students. How can scholarship be the subject of this sentence? Oh, like my dissertation, Jefa. She'd say that sentence is awkward. In addition, at no instance does it say that Knox is an organization that condones sexual assault or harassment. Then why has the organization condoned it? In a letter issued by the Knox board, it was indicated that, quote, given the historical prevalence of dismissing allegations of sexual assault, end quote. Thus, the board has admitted two things. First, that there has been a history of sexual assault within the organization, and second, that these allegations have usually been dismissed. The letter was distributed with the purpose of informing the membership that five women had, quote, come forward to longtime community leaders with serious allegations of sexual harassment and assault against one of the directors slash producers of the film, Precious Knowledge. These alleged events took place in Tucson, Arizona in March of 2011, end quote. Precious Knowledge, 2011. Quote, Precious Knowledge interweaves the transformative stories of students in the Mexican American Studies program at Tucson High School. The program has become a model of educational success with 100% of their students graduating from high school and 82% attending college. We filmed their social justice throughout an entire school year to document disenfranchised youth becoming engaged, informed, and active Chicanos. However, Arizona lawmakers believe the students are being indoctrinated with dangerous ideology and that the classes teach anti-American, anti-capitalist, destructive ethnic chauvinism. Precious Knowledge is a co-production of Dos Patos Productions and the Independent Television Service, produced in association with Latino Public Broadcasting and Arizona Public Media, with funding provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting, CPB, end quote.
Solos los dos, me puse a temblar cuando él se acercó a mí. Pude sentir que no tendría voluntad, apenas y dije no. Y él me empezó a desnudar y me puse a llorar poco después del final. Sus ojos, su adiós, me dieron la verdad. Pude saber que él no sería para mí y yo sí para mí, aunque nunca lo vuelva a ver, aunque nunca lo vuelva a ver.
About the filmmakers, Ari Luis Palos was the director, and Aaron Isabel McGinnis was the producer. So the perpetrator was either the director or the producer. It could be the man, it could be the woman, or it could also be one of the people involved in the production. In response to the letter sent by Knox, Trinidad Gonzalez responded in an email, quote, has a sexual assault complaint, I think he meant complaint, been filed with local law enforcement? If so, what has been the outcome of their investigation? If not, why not? Whereas sexual harassment will be dealt internally and or later with the EEOC or the courts, assault should be immediately reported to law enforcement. Trinidad Gonzalez. Dear Trinidad, the fact that you were the only Chicana within the Tejas Foco to respond to the letter is, in my opinion, admirable. There is at least one Chicano who finds it important to address the issues raised in the letter. Your suggestions are the common responses we usually give when issues of sexual harassment and assault arise, because we know that they are wrong and that the perpetrators must be brought to justice. However, we must consider what the victims want to do, and we must respect those wishes. Dear Trinidad, the five women have approached the leadership within Knox. To me, this indicates that they wish to have their concerns addressed within the organization. However, this leaves me wondering the following. How will Knox address this issue? Who is the perpetrator? At this point, whether the alleged perpetrator may or may not be a member of Knox is irrelevant. What is relevant is whether individuals who have been accused of sexual improprieties within the organization continue to be members of the organization without any repercussions. Remember that the organization itself admitted to, quote, historically dismissing allegations of sexual assault, end quote. For example, if Rudy Acuna were accused of sexual harassment and or assault, would the allegations at Knox be dismissed because he is the, quote unquote, father of Chicano studies? Got history? Today, Chicanas, Chicanos continue in the struggle for civil rights, much like our elders did back in the 1960s. We are fighting for Chicana, Chicano studies in education. While programs are being dismantled and books being quote-unquote locked up, we have people like Rudy Acuna, who wrote one of the most foundational books in Chicano studies, Being a Bully Towards Women. Then we have Maylee Blackwell uncovering Mexicana's agency during the Mexican Revolution and Chicana's agency during the Chicana-Chicano movement that nationalist discourses have historically erased. But then we have Chicanas like Blackwell disrespecting other Chicanas in Chicana-Chicano academic spaces. Then we have filmmakers directing and producing films such as Precious Knowledge that highlight Chicana-Chicano studies at Tucson High School and the positive effect that such a program has had on Chicana-Chicano graduation. But then these same directors, producers are accused of sexual harassment and assault towards women! Like WTF. If you need a refresher about abuse, check out the movie Precious, 2009, or the book Las Hijas de Juan, Daughters Betrayed by Méndez Negrete, 2006. Chicanas and Chicanos, check yourselves. For many of you, your ethical framework and politics don't stand on shit. Next video. My next video is on my memoirs of harassment in the workplace as a doctoral student and as a bilingual teacher. This time, I'm naming people. It is my belief that if people and their shit are made public, then they will think twice before they harass people in the workplace. And this is Irma Vargas Rosas reporting to you from Illinois. Check out my website at www.irmarosas.com.